Hello and welcome. My name is Kai Sporleder. I'm a PhD student at Fraunhofer CSP, and in this presentation I will show you results of potential induced degradation at the rear site of bifacial PERC solar cells. Here's the outline of the talk. We will first see why PV modules in power plants suffer from potential induced degradation, and then we will see why especially bifacial solar cells are sensitive to PID at the rear site. The PID mechanisms that can occur at the rear site, especially for bifacial solar cells from the PERC type, are PID of the depolarization type and PID of the corrosive type. But the PID sensitivity on cell level can be reduced in an adapted cell process. We will see illuminated PID test results here, and we will end with a summary. Let's have a look at the conditions that lead to potential induced degradation in PV power plants. In power plants, the PV modules are connected in series so that the voltages of the modules sum up and can reach several hundreds of volts. Now, depending on where your system is grounded, the inner of the module, which means the solar cells, can be at a high positive or high negative potential compared to the grounded frame. If then a conductive film, maybe due to moisture or dust, is applied on the surface, an electric field forms out that can direct through the glass and encapsulation material as well as through the passivating layer, which will cause leakage currents that can damage your cell. This is basically what happens in PID. We've seen that the potential difference between the grounded frame and the solar cell is the root cause for potential induced degradation. And when you have a look at a bifacial solar cell at the right side and a monofacial solar cell at the left side, you can see that the conventional cell, which has a fully covering metallization at the rear side, is shielded against leakage currents, but the bifacial cell is not shielded since this metallization is missing. This leads to additional leakage current paths into the cell that can activate two different mechanisms of potential induced degradation, which we will see on the next slide. The first mechanism that is relevant for our bifacial PERC technology is PID of the depolarization type. This mechanism is not new, it was already described by Swanson in 2005, and Luo used it to explain his findings for PID tests at bifacial PERC modules. To understand what happens, we'll have a look at the rear side of a bifacial PERC cell. In the initial state, fixed negative charges within the aluminum oxide layers lead to a bending of the energy band. These fixed negative charges stem from excess oxygen. And if then your PV module operates in a string at the negative end of the string, currents of positively charged ions flow into the passivating layers and compensate your negative charges so that recombination of the at the rear surface increases. And this mechanism is named PIDP due to depolarization of the field effect passivation. The second mechanism that is relevant for our bifacial PERC technology is PID of the corrosive type, which leads to structural defects at the rear surface. And we will see on a mini module what happens. In the initial state, the electroluminescence image is homogeneously bright, and due to increased recombination, the radiative recombination is reduced in the degraded state. The degraded image in this case on a macroscopic scale looks very homogeneous, but going on a small spot with higher resolution, in this case we use light beam induced current, one finds that a huge amount of very localized spots occurs where electrons and holes recombine. Going even more into detail using scanning electron microscopy, one finds that holes within the rear side passivating layers occur, and underneath the passivating layer silicon dioxide forms. We therefore named this mechanism PID of the corrosive type, or short PIDC. An interesting and also very important point is now that illumination during the PID test plays an important role. Luo has shown that simultaneous illumination during the PID test for irradiance levels as low as 10 watt per square meter is sufficient to completely suppress PID. And this is shown in the right diagram for industrially produced PERC modules. While in the dark, a severe degradation in the power is observed, which is mainly due to ISC losses and VOC losses, while the fill factor is not affected in this case. Switching on a light source during the high voltage stress, the degradation is completely prevented. In opposite to these findings, our tests at Fraunhofer CSP show that a degradation can occur although simultaneous illumination is used, and these tests were performed on industrially produced bifacial PERC cells, which were made from P-type monowafers, which are the same cell type as Luo used in his tests. And this does mean that PID of the corrosive type and PID of the depolarization type are relevant under field conditions, since our results show that simultaneous illumination does not automatically prevent potential-induced degradation. And interestingly, since all these results were done or achieved from the very same cell type, it is possible to suppress PID under illumination. And this is the state that we want to get. And this is achievable by adapting the cell process. This is the setup that we use for our standard PID tests in the dark. We locally apply an EVA and glass. And please note that the rear side of the solar cell is tested in this orientation. The high voltage is applied between front, between a contact on top and a contact at the bottom. This is the setup that is used in the PID con. To realize simultaneous illumination, we have adapted the setup and we now use glasses which are coated with transparent conductive oxides. This allows light to enter the cell during a high voltage is applied. With our setups, we have performed a PID test in the dark and a PID test under illumination for a solar cell from an adapted cell process. And we use internal quantum efficiency measurements and photoluminescence measurements to assess the extent of degradation. And from internal quantum efficiency, we see that there is a degradation. And we can use external quantum efficiency to calculate ISC. And we see that compared to the initial state, we have an ISC loss of about 15% in the degraded state at the rear side. And we see that the region that was stressed is darker in the photoluminescence image due to reduced lifetime in the degraded state. But when we compare these results to PID tests in the dark for the very same cell type, we see that the quantum efficiency drops much stronger in the dark PID test, and also the photoluminescence image shows a stronger reduced lifetime under VOC conditions. to and the IC current calculated from external quantum efficiency shows a drop of 72%. In comparison to these findings, when we use a standard cell and perform an illuminated test, we see that when you don't take care of your rear surface processes, you can have severe power losses at the rear side, which reflects in a strongly reduced internal quantum efficiency. Also, ISC calculations show that ISC from the rear side will drop by about 80%. And you also see in photoluminescence imaging that you have severely reduced lifetime. And here it is worth to notice that our tests are designed in a way to test the extent of quantum of potential induced degradation at cell level. So we used an EVA which is prone to PID, and this also means that when you use an adapted cell process and you design your module with an high resistance EVA, you have good chance to prevent PID at the rear side in PV modules. In the end, I would like to give you an overview about PID mechanisms that can affect bifacial silicon solar cells. One effect at the front side, which was not the topic of the talk today, is PIDS, or PID of the shunting type. It shunts the PN junction, and the root cause is that sodium decorates stacking faults and creates current paths through the PN junction. This reflects in a drop of the shunt resistance and in a reduced fill factor. And thinking in a double diode model, the second diode parameters changes. Shunting type PID can be recovered by high temperatures or reverse voltages, but only if the power loss doesn't exceed a level of about 50%. At the rear side, we have PID of the depolarization type, or PIDP. It is due to compensation of the field effect passivation, and the affected parameters are ISC and VOC. It can be recovered by dark storage or illumination at elevated temperatures. And last, we have PIDC, which is due to a corrosion of the silicon beneath the passivating layers at the rear side, and it affects ISC and VOC. So from the affected parameters, depolarization PID and corrosive PID cannot be distinguished. This is possible by performing recovery experiments, since corrosive PID does not recover. To summarize my talk, PID of the depolarization type and corrosive PID can damage the rear side passivation of silicon solar cells. And the susceptibility to PIDP and PIDC is highly variable for the same technology. We therefore recommend regular cell tests. But you also have the chance already on cell level to reduce the PID sensitivity. And we also recommend that meaningful PID tests at the rear side should include simultaneous illumination. To realize these new PID tests, Freiberg Instruments has upgraded their PIDCon to a PIDCon bifacial. The new device contains simultaneous illumination and allows an automatic discrimination between PIDP and PIDC. And it also is able to switch the voltages between high negative and high positive voltages, which is useful for N-type and P-type solar cells. In the end, I would like to thank the German Federal Ministry of Education and Research and the German Federal Ministry for Economic Affairs and Energy for financial supports of the projects PID Recovery and Next Step. And of course, I would like to thank you for watching. Thank you. And if you have any questions, please feel free to contact me.